Each week on this video, we'll give you sneaky waiver wire ads that you could pick up and plug right into your lineup. I'm Alan Soslowski here with Jeff Erickson. Jeff, the injuries are starting to add up. People need help. Who's your first sneaky ad?
First sneaky ad is one of the many Cleveland guys we'll be looking at. D'Ernest Johnson, though, is the guy I'm looking at. We know Kareem Hunt is out for multiple weeks with this calf injury, likely going on the IR. By the time you hear this and watch this, he probably is on the IR already. Nick Chubb is a possibility to come back this week, according to Kevin Stefanski, but I don't know. It's the same sort of calf injury there. We'll see. It was one that wouldn't allow him to practice at all last week, and they have the short week. They play Thursday against Denver. So D'Ernest Johnson has got a good chance of being the lead back. He's lining up at running back, whereas Dimitri Felton's more lining up at receiver more often than not. So Felton's actually a better PPR guy. Johnson's the guy that's going to get the work, I think. Even if Chubb comes back, I think Johnson's going to get plenty of work this week.
Who's your second best sneaky ad for week 7?
Second best ad is Nico Collins, wide receiver for the Houston Texans. He was hurt to start the year with a shoulder injury. Actually got hurt on the first offensive play of the season. He gathered a lot of buzz in preseason. He's a third round pick out of Michigan. You know, he's a field stretcher. He's a guy that can actually do a lot here. I'm excited about him. Houston was getting by with the likes of Chris Conley and anybody named Chris. Everybody hates Chris, but everybody named Chris was getting something right there. Collins against the Colts went four catches, 6 targets, 44 yards. They're at Arizona this week. You know they're going to be throwing it constantly. So Collins should get a lot of work this week.
Seems like the rich man's Donovan Peoples-Jones, right? The two Michigan receivers. I like that a lot, especially our call last week of Donovan Peoples-Jones. He came through for us. No longer a sneaky ad. Give me another one. Is there any other receivers out there other than Nico Collins right now that I could pick up?
Yeah, Rashad Bateman. Now, I used ESPN as my standard this week. I want to spread the love there. Did Yahoo last week, but this week, Rashad Bateman's still available in all but 14.6% of ESPN leagues. So the rookie out of Baltimore, first round pick, got 4 targets last week. Actually, he got 6 targets also last week, but only 29 yards. Keep in mind, though, they were smoking the Chargers. So they didn't really need to air it out a whole lot. They get a home game, big division game against the Bengals. Quietly, this has become a big game this week. So we'll watch to see what happens there. But I think Bateman's going to be a guy that is going to make some big plays later on this season. You may have to be a little patient with him. But he's the type of guy you want to add, not just chasing stats from last week. I think he's someone that can help you and someone that can be a dynamic player in the long run.
With everybody spending up on the rookie wide receivers, they're exciting, and maybe the Cleveland running backs, is there another sneaky running back that I might be able to sneak through and get for a few dollars?
Yeah, Antonio Gibson's looking like Fred Sanford every week there. He's limping off. He's getting, this is the big injury. Oh, and he needs some help. He's getting an MRI on his calf now.
There goes our under 50 audience right there with the Fred Sanford reds.
Once again, going for the youth. This was going straight to TikTok. Getting checked out for a calf injury this week, and he just looks bad. Just looks hurt, banged up. Some weeks he does get the work and still gets you his production, but other weeks he's really hurting us. Jarrett Patterson is a guy who was a big producer in college, had his own big injury to deal with there. Now he might be the guy that steps in and get a chance. J.D. McKissick's there, and they do want to use McKissick a lot, but they prefer to still use him in the passing game. If Gibson can't go, Patterson's someone that should be rostered.
Since you watched this video until the end, Jeff, do you have any bonus sneaky ads for us this week?
I want to hang the DJ. Go DJ Dallas, Seattle Seahawks here. Alex Collins, great on Sunday night, actually. Good cutback runner, but he's dealing with a hip. He's getting an MRI on Monday, so that's something to watch for. He was out of the game late. Dallas got a lot more snaps than Travis Homer. He got 22 snaps on the Sunday night game. So he's the guy I view as next in line, even though Homer's got some upside too, and they might still get Rashad Penny. So this is kind of a... this is a desperation play here. This is a deeper league play that you want to go after him, DJ Dallas.
For the super flex players where you have to start two quarterbacks, is there anyone out there this week? Last week we ran out to get Geno Smith, lukewarm production, still better than starting, the fourth or fifth receiver on your bench. We had about 12 to 15 fantasy points. Is there anybody that we could even speculate on, a backup quarterback, anyone that can help us get through the bye weeks?
Whatever the case may be, Case Keenum in Cleveland, I think, might be the case here, because Baker Mayfield re-injured his shoulder, although, as Liss likes to say, he faked the injury to cover up for that bad fumble. But no, I think he's actually legit hurt. But they play Thursday night, so they don't have a whole lot of time to turn it around. If Mayfield can't do anything in practice this week, I can see them going with Keenum.
To see RotoWire's fantasy football premium content and all of Jeff's weekly rankings, his value meter, go to rotowire.com/try. We also have our fantasy basketball draft kit and premium content articles and rankings up there as well. Go to rotowire.com/try and you can see all of our content for free for 10 days.